Okay. Done.
Hi guys. In the last session, we discussed or we just understood very basic knowledge about automata. And in this session, we'll just have some more information, basically some normal information, basic information about this automata and what are the prerequisites required to study this subject. Before going to that, I make it very much clear, this or these videos what I'm uploading would be focusing on the syllabus framed by VTU as per CBCS scheme from the academic year 2015-16. So let me focusing on that particular syllabus itself. Anyhow, the syllabus is not matching with any other universities as well. Let me start with the discussion. In the last class, I just told an automata, definition of it, then the language required for it, and the grammar. I just gave a glimpse of it. Today, let me understand what is exactly mean a language and what are the basic elements required for a language. As soon as I say the word language, as I said, it is a communication medium. See, you know, whenever you want to communicate with your friend, you talk to him in a language which he understands. It might be an oral communication or a sign communication or a written communication. Ultimately, whatever the communication you make, all those communication happens only through the understanding format. So in unit 1 or module 1, we discuss what is a study or why should we study theory of computer. What is a language? What is a string? And also, we just discuss on finite state machines in this module. Now, coming back to language. As I said, language is a communication media. Understand that whenever I want to communicate with a machine, I should know what machine understands. It's very much clear that whatever I understand, that is not able to understand by the system or a machine. So I should make system to understand whatever I want to communicate. Now, when I say this is a machine, I want to communicate, I should know what is the language used. For that reason, I now understand what is the language, what is the basic elements of a language. So now, I just focus on language elements. When I say language, I have told many a times it's a communication channel or a communication medium. And here, or any language, I say, languages are made up of what is called as alphabets. You know English alphabet, you know German alphabet or French alphabet or Kannada alphabet. So whenever I talk about an alphabet, I should know what it is. So alphabet is a finite set of symbols. Many of them may define alphabets in many ways. Probably you may say it is character, something and all, but basically, when I say alphabet, it's a set of symbol. Understand the word symbol here. See, I can say these symbols as A, B, C, D, which is of English, only when I know to identify that this symbol is A. If I doesn't know this symbol was A, I will just say this some symbol. Say, for example, if an unknown person reads this symbol, until he doesn't know what is the symbol, he just say it's a symbol. After knowing the symbol, he may say this is a character A in the language Kannada. Similarly, before knowing any identification of a symbol, I just say it as a symbol. So that I can say alphabet is a finite set of symbols, where the set of symbols is indicated by the symbol called as sigma. Whenever I use a letter sigma, that is termed as alphabet in the subject. So, I can now understand what is an alphabet. Alphabet is finite set of symbols. Once I know the definition of alphabet, then I should know what is string. String, sometimes we can also call it as a word, but not in a specific meaning. When I say string, I say string is collection of symbols. Collection of symbols. Now, Understand two things. One, when I say language is this, fine issues. I define some alphabets in a language. I frame I collect or I make a string using some of the alphabets. It might be all the alphabets, it might be some alphabets. Again, we are not worried about meaning here. So don't conclude or don't link this with English words or any natural language words. So better not to involve the definition of word here. So symbols, collection of symbols or group of symbols is said to be string. That is our final conclusion as of now. When I say string, I should also understand something with this. I should know what is substring. I should know what is power of string. Okay. For example, before going to this, if I say sigma as 0, 1, which is said to be a binary language, I can say strings could be 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, anything. These are all called as strings now. Okay, fine. Coming back to substring and power of string. Substring is a part of a string. Say suppose, if I have considered string as 1, 1, 1, 1, I can say this is a substring, a part of a string. Similarly, when you talk about power of a string, very much required, very much important to understand, where power of string indicates or denotes number of occurrences of the symbol in a given alphabet, that is usually denoted by sigma power I, where suppose if I say sigma power 0, it is 0 number of symbols, we say 0 symbols. Sigma power 1 is said to be 1 symbol. So now understand, sigma is an alphabet. Sigma power 0, 0 indicates number of occurrences of that particular symbol. When I say 0 occurrences of symbol, it means there are no symbols at all, where I have a language but no input symbols. Normally, this can be denoted by the symbol called as epsilon. So when I say epsilon, this is a symbol we use to denote sigma 0. Similarly, if I say sigma 1, it is one occurrence of any symbol in a given language, in a given alphabet. If you say this is an alphabet 0 and 1, I can say sigma 1 is either 0 or 1. Similarly, if I say sigma 2, it could be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Ultimately, whenever I talk about power of a string, it clearly says number of occurrences of a symbol in a given alphabet. So in this, we discussed the definition of language, the definition of alphabet, definition of string, and few things about string. Next, we'll discuss another basic parts of it. What is a language in detail, the language hierarchy, and we move on to finite state automata or finite state machine. Thank you.